Good evening, everyone. This is Vineet Pandey, and this is Midnight. Yes, this is Midnight actually, and I'm in my classroom because a lot of students, they are allowed to sit in my classes so that they can study properly. Today, I came here to just have an idea that how this study is going on. One of my students asked me, so can you please just tell me reader response theory? Because we still have to complete this theory portion in my classes. So I just try to teach them. And after that, I thought I can use the same video, same blackboard thing for you guys. So I'll request my cameraman to focus on reader response theory so that I can give you the rest of the details. Friends, first thing we'll have to understand that with the rise of new criticism and formalism or the formalist theories, people started questioning the authenticity of the writer. People, they came with the idea that once the book is published, there is no value of the author. There is no need of the author because once the text is published, the text becomes autonomous. No doubt, the text is autonomous, but then who has the actual value now? So here the people, reader response theory, also called reception aesthetics. They simply believe that if there is no role of the author left, then the actual role of the reader comes here. And here we call this, that in the words of Roland Barthes, death of the author can be taken as the birth of the reader. So here the second entity, the reader, becomes very important because reader is the second author. Reader creates the meaning of the author. Now how do we get the meaning of the text? How do we try to understand the text? Now here comes an easy question that how do we realize this book is a classic, that book is a classic, or what are the assumptions when we try to study a book? How do we relate it to ourselves? How do we get the actual content of the story, actual content of the book, or the essence of the book? Many of you have studied Longinus for his work on Sublime, on the Sublime. So there was a theory that Sublime works are which are evergreen, Sublime works are which are classics, Sublime works which are amazingly good, and they convey the common message and they are far away from any influence, any impact of any metalistic thing that are called classics or Sublime. Here they studied that transportation theory. If a work makes you transported to the world of the writer, that calls transportation theory, and if the book has that standard to simply send you, to get you involved in the story, that is called classic, that is called Sublime. So here the question comes that no doubt the reader is the more important character. Reader has to study the book. How a reader declares the book a classic, how a reader rejects the book as a classic. A lot of people, they are of the view that media is a classic, Anna Karenina is a classic, Madame Bovary is a classic. Then many of you have your own opinions. So here we're going to study that how do we understand what is reader response theory? Because the rise of middle class, the changes in readership, the use of psychological messages, the condition of women in society, the industrialization, this have simply affected readership. And that's the reason we need to focus on these theories. So the first theory that comes to us is interpretive community. Interpretive community is, we need to understand that the reader belongs to a particular genre. So for example, if a reader comes from South Asian countries, or if a reader comes from a particular religion, maybe Hinduism, Islam, or any other good religion, great religion, he will have a different kind of interpretation of any text. For example, I give you a very simple example where Candida in G.B. Shaw chooses her husband. If you have read G.B. Shaw's Candida, you'll find out that Candida's husband has a debate with Marchbank, Eugene Marchbank, and where Candida selects to stay with her husband. She says that I cannot leave my husband, I will always live beside my husband. But what was the theme behind that? The theme behind that was, Candida says, I have to be with somebody who is weaker than me, so that I can make my existence, so that I can have my strong value. Had it been in Indian scenario, Candida must have said, Bhala hai, bura hai, jaisa bhi hai, mera pati, mera devta hai. So the message is that if this is an Indian scenario, Indian readership, they want that a lady should accept her husband in any condition. We follow Manusmriti. In Manusmriti, it has been clearly mentioned that even if the husband is a rogue, a criminal, he is always a god for women. So our readership, the Indian ethnic readership, we want the lady to be with her husband because her culture wants to do this. But in Candida, her identity wants her to be with the weaker one so that Candida can be strongly accepted in the relation. So that's called interpretive community. Repeating again, interpretive community is that if we have 10 readers from 10 different countries with 10 different mindset, 10 different genders, ideologies, identities, and they are reading one book, they will have various assumptions. For example, Salman Rushdie's Satanic Verses troubled this insulted Islam. So we have criticized that book, we don't want that book, but in various countries it is being read, it is being circulated. Then the next term we have is implied reader. Implied reader is a term by Wolfgang Iser. He's of the view that when a writer writes, he always has this thing in his mind to get the ideal reader, the actual reader. When a writer encodes his messages, he simply wants to be understood to the core, to the best of it. But it becomes apparently impossible to have the implied reader. Implied reader can also be called ideal reader, right? After this, we're going to talk about the next term. The next term we have is horizons of expectation. Horizons of expectation is when you go to buy a book, being a reader, you bring certain assumptions to the work, and these assumptions make you go for a biased study of the work. For example, how many of you buy the books just because you know the name of the writer? So you go to the bookshop and you say, sir, please give me some Chetan Bhagat, give me some Ravinder Singh, or give me some any book by the name of the writer, because you have heard the value of the writer. Do you go to the bookshop saying, sir, please take my 500 and give me any book? No, you always have the preference. Even if you don't know the writer, the other thing that attracts you is the title. The luring title, the cover page that attracts you. So the cover page makes you think about the book. The title makes you feel about the book, that there is something in the book, and you buy this book. So how do it happen to trouble your study? Because when you study the patterns, titles, color, cover pages that make you feel, you start expecting from the book. That's called horizons of expectation. That means a wrong study. For example, many of the students and the scholars, they bought a famous work of Edward Elby to study. It was Who is Afraid of Virginia Woolf. They thought that it is having the name of Virginia Woolf, so it must be very easy, something related to feminism. They bought it, and what they found was totally different. A lot of people bought the same writer's another book, Who is Sylvia. They thought it to be a book related to Sylvia Plath, but they found it's a goat, not Sylvia Plath. In fact, one day, I have my own experience. I was going to buy a book where the title was My Husband and Other Animal. It was by Janki Lenin. But then I happened to read few pages and I got to know that it's not related to domestic fight, domestic troubles. It's something related to different thing. Here we're going to talk about the writers. We have Norman Holland. Norman Holland is the first writer that in his seminar, which is famously called Delphi Seminar. Delphi Seminar. He tried to have the interpretations of poems from various point of views, which is famously called Delphi style or Delphi seminar style. Then do not forget the names of the writer like Wolfgang Iser, Stanley Fish, Norman Holland, Roland Barthes, Hans Joss, and many others. So friends, repeating again, these are the most important theories, and this is reader response. If you have more suggestions, more questions, you can simply contact me on 85870-35827. Thank you so much. This is Vineet Pandey.